This is part two to the collective astrological pop-up reading. Okay? Part one ended with me speaking about how Jupiter and Saturn are both transit into the zodiac sign of Capricorn. And due to this, there will be no more delays. No more delays. Meaning, you will no longer have to wait for your blessings. Your seeds have already been sowed. You've already watered your plants. You've just been waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. And we've just been looking at the time, looking at the clock, looking at the stars. And you just like, Lord, when? And this is the time when all that has been stagnant or all that has been held back from you is going to be given to you. So there's going to be no more stagnation. This is why we have the world, which is clarifying the Ace of Pentacles. Now we're going to move into the reading. We have the Ace of Pentacles, clarified by the world. Then we have the Queen of Wands. That's the near future energies. And the outcome, we have the Four of Swords, right? We have judgment and we have justice. Now, this can be either, this reading can go two ways. Now, there are twin flames here. Divine Feminine, you are the Queen of Wands. You are in the energies of the Queen of Wands. Now, if you are in your masculine energies, this reading will be vice versa, okay? So the Divine Feminine is in her energy of feeling ambitious. She's feeling creative. She feels this burst of new energy. She's just ready to take on the world, okay? That is the energy that the Divine Feminine is feeling. Now, the Ace of Pentacles is a solid offer. A solid offer that could either be a business offer, okay? Now, that don't seem like an offer. I'm sorry. Not offer. My apologies. Promotion. A business promotion. Okay? This pentacle can either be inheritance. It could either be a lawsuit. Could be a legal settlement. Okay? Anything of that matter. But you have abundance. The Divine Feminine has abundance coming in. Okay? That abundance is clarified by the world. Now, some of you Divine Feminists could be traveling the world. Okay? Some of this abundance coming in could have been exactly what you needed in order to move forward, in order to do what it is that you've always wanted to do. You understand what I'm saying? So it's like with this abundance coming in, no more stagnation with the energy of Saturn and Jupiter, both transiting in the zodiac sign of Capricorn, no more stagnations. So here is your pentacle. So the universe is giving you okay. The universe is giving you, she is giving you your okay to do all that it is that you've always wanted to do. She is giving you your blessing. The blessings that you have been waiting for. So some of you Divine Feminines are going to be traveling the world. Yes, you are going to be traveling the world. So we have the world is clarifying. The pentacle, that is a ending of a cycle. You are ending a cycle. So the Divine Feminine right now is ending a cycle. She's ending a cycle of karmic debt. She's ending a cycle of toxicity. She's ending a cycle of hardship. She's ending a cycle of poverty. She's ending cycles. She's making the shit happen. Crawling and all to the finish line. The Divine Feminine is making the shit happen. And I'm sorry I had to get so intense like that. But I'm just like in those energies right now. Damn. Because I'm like, I'm there with y'all. Like, I'm right there with y'all. Y'all don't know. I am. So it's like, I feel the intensity of like, I'm almost there. I'm almost there. Just like, you're right there at the finish line. You can feel it. It's just like, right there. But keep pushing. Keep pushing, baby girl. You almost there. You are almost there. I'm telling you, you almost there. You are much closer than you think. You are much more closer than you think. A lot of times I have to go back to listen to my videos because it's like my higher self giving messages to me, from me. It's like from the future. You understand what I'm saying? Very powerful. So the divine feminine is ending the cycle. She's feeling fiery. She's feeling sexy. You can't tell her. You can't tell her nothing. You look. I feel sorry for the person who cries too, because she ain't having it. She got that wand up, but that wand, she can alchemy that wand into a sword real quick. Y'all better ask somebody about that queen wand. She fired. She don't play. That's divine feminine. That's the energy that you are in right now. In the energy of fire, passion. You're feeling passionate, just passionate about life. Even during your downfall, even during your struggles, you're just feeling passionate about life. Like you're feeling passionate about that struggle that you're in now. Passionate about overcoming that. Passionate about seeing who you become after you overcome that, after you experience that pain. Through that particular experience, you know what I'm saying? Or through your particular experiences. Beautiful. Beautiful. Cycles ending. Divine feminine cycles ending. Now we're moving to divine masculine. Hi there. The divine masculines are coming out of feeling burdened. They are coming out of feeling stressed. They are finally sleeping. They are finally resting. Okay? They are resting. They are in a resting. They are contemplating. They are thinking. They are in a state now of rest. Okay? And they are calling judgment on a situation. Clearly, there was a separation. This is why the lovers are separated. That's why the lovers were... Okay, that's why the love was clarified. Not only are you twin flames, but you were both in separation. That's why the lovers... Okay. So you were both in separation. The divine masculine is now in the energies of wanting to bring judgment to it. He's calling judgment on the situation. And he's willing to bring justice to this situation. This is why the reading is crowned by 1111, the Four of Wands, which is stability, marriage, fulfillment, happy home, happy family. Now, for those of you that were just for the twin flames, those of you who aren't twin flames, this reading still applies. You are coming into a practical, financial, life-changing opportunity that's going to allow you, that's going to help assist you to travel the world and do all the things that you've always wanted to do. You're feeling passionate about your future. You're feeling passionate about all the things that you can do with this abundance, and with this raise, or with this promotion, with this whatever type of practicality that finance brings to you. But that is what you are. That is the energy that you are embodying now. Okay. So, in the past, you may have had as I mentioned, you remember I was talking about stagnations. We are coming out of the energy's feeling stagnation. You are worried about finances. You're feeling you are coming out of that energy now, which is explained before swords. You're coming out of that energy. You're feeling relief now because you no longer have to focus on, or you no longer have to worry about finances because now you are in a more stable situation financial wise, you know, given that you have this new abundance coming in. Now, if you're not feeling that relief now, you're going to receive that abundance and, you know, you're going to be feeling a lot more lighter, really. So you are, the divine spirit of life is bringing judgment in your situations, calling judgment in your situation, and justice is being served. So you are receiving a pentacle, which can indicate, as I mentioned, a job raise, a promotion, lawsuit, legal settlement, anything that's such. Okay, that's the energy that you are embodying. Okay, that's what you have to look forward to. Now, some of you this is what I'm picking up on now. So some of you are going through legal matters now regarding divorce. Okay, you are in court now for divorce matters. Those of you who are in court for divorce matters, if you are cross-watching, you are on the short end of the stick. If you are not cross-watching, if you are watching for yourself, then you are not on the short end of the stick. You have the pentacle. So basically, it's so much more than to it than, you know, cross-watching or not. It's if you were good in that situation, if you were in that situation in your marriage and you had good intentions throughout your entire marriage, you are going to come out of this divorce settlement successful. You are going to be successful. If you have pure intentions, if you maintain pure intentions throughout your entire marriage, you are going to be successful in this legal, in this, within this divorce settlement. Okay? That's all I have for you guys. I thank you all for joining me. And until next time, Divine Feminines, Divine Masculines, congratulations. Some of you are literally about to come into union with the love of your life. Oh, let me stop because I know I'll geek out. Anywho, I'm excited for you all. With that being said, peace, love, and light. Asha.